Can I be honest with you guys? As a guy who makes a lot of reptile videos for YouTube, I don't watch a lot of content that involves reptiles on YouTube. And the worst for that's gonna be reptile shows. However, I love reptile shows. I go to them as often as I can. And I'm not saying all, but the majority of most videos. Today I wanna address, why do reptile show videos suck? Now, you've got production value, you've got high quality videos that can be made at reptile shows. Some people have really nice cameras. But if the content's not good, that doesn't matter. And so I'm gonna address some of the things that you can do to help make your reptile show videos stand out if you're making that kind of content. And if you're watching it, what kind of content that you should be looking for if you're looking for quality content. So behind me is a very rare sight at a reptile show, and that's gonna be a ball python breeder.
Not funny!
So my biggest quirk with reptile show videos is that they'll pan across the displays for ball pythons, and there's no content there because they don't talk about any of the snakes involved. They just go across and they set it to music.
Sure, so this is a Butterfire Yellow Belly Double Het Clown genetic stripe. We produced her this year. It's a really cool pattern, nice colors. Love her head.
So that's a snake that's so cool that they decided they're not even gonna sell it. It's a good combination of genes. Now, if you love ball pythons, that's a good thing that you would wanna talk about. But a lot of the videos I see, they'll pan across a snake like that and not talk about it. So if that's all you're doing, what's the difference between that and just scrolling through Morph Market and going to Google Images?
So another thing I've wanted for a really long time is a squab, because they're like Skittles. They come in so many different colors, and it's just great. And I love Skittles, and I love squabs. So make sure you show off interesting species, stuff that a lot of people might not know a lot about. So squabs are a pretty popular venomous snake if you're in the venomous hobby, but it gets outside of the ball pythons, leopard geckos, crested geckos that are always shown on the channel. You can do it so many times, and there's a lot to do with them, but make sure you show off some different species. So one of the big things about reptile shows is the people that you get to consistently see every time you come to one of these shows. It's like getting to see a friend that you haven't seen in a long time. One of those people is gonna be Brent here from Venom Lab. So Brent and I, we're gonna go around and we're gonna do what's called a walkabout talkabout, where anything can happen.
Bye.
Bye. And so we're gonna go around and we're just gonna discuss the different people you get to see, be friends with, and how the community helps each other. And I'm gonna let Brent talk a little bit about some of the things that you can experience at a Herps Reptile Show as far as community goes.
One of the things that people really miss is the human experience, the human aspect. There's a ton of people that this is the only time of the year that we get to see them. Bryce.
I didn't know that.
Wow, that is such a really nice shirt.
It is.
It is a very nice shirt. I walked by and I saw the shirt and I was like, that's
just perfect.
Oh yeah. Well, what you doing later? You want me to buy you a drink? I'm gonna buy you a drink later for wearing that shirt.
Yeah. Okay. I'll take it.
Three samples.
In my opinion, the thing that really makes reptile shows your videos a lot better is learn your morphs. Learn the different your species, your morphs, because if I'm just panning through looking at stuff, like I wanna talk about what it is.
So another thing about reptile show videos that you gotta do is you gotta make sure that you do things that normally aren't done. In my case, that's playing with Dakota Monday. Feel like a pirate anyway.
What is it?
Dakota Monday. People are looking at me, not you, and I'm like,
Dakota Monday, is that
It's like, I'm figuring this out. Look at those teeth.
So another thing that a lot of people don't do with reptile videos is interact. They don't ask questions, they don't engage. For instance, here we've got the focus brick. This is a brick model. They also have focus cubes for awesome animals. But you look at a paint job like this and you wonder what animal would work best in there. So let me know down below, what animal would you put if you had an enclosure that looked like this? Reptile Gumbo Podcast. He's going to talk a little bit about the people he talks to and the people he meets.
So most podcasts are interview style, and I didn't want to go interview based. I wanted to do more of a talk about what's going on currently, kind of like the sports center of herpetoculture, review what's going on in that week. So on our podcast, there's three main hosts, myself, my wife Katie, and my co-host Robert. And then every week we bring in a different co-host to join us, someone with a different background, different viewpoints, to really get an idea of what everybody's saying. And then we just have discussions. And each week we post questions online for our viewers to answer so we can get their opinions. It's really a big community thing. We even started a whole community Facebook page for people to get onto and talk. So Reptile Gumbo Podcast weekly. Check us out on Facebook. And we, like I said, we post questions every week. You can answer, let us know what you think.
And I will link them in the description down below, as well as a little pin up there on places that you can find them. And go check them out. It gets a good deep dive into information. It doesn't just skim the surface, it dives deep. So the next big thing about being in this community is us being there for each other when one of us needs help.
We had, through US ARC, there's tons of donations that go out all the time. We had Chase, we, as a community, helped him through his brain cancer. We had so many things through NARBC with Tel Hicks and his injury on his neck. We had JT just last year. They lost their entire house and most of their animals to a fire. And the community stepped up and donated. So many people in this community donated.
Jay and I with Gecko Element were victims of Hurricane Laura and Hurricane Delta in Lake Charles, Louisiana in 2020. And thankfully, we had the Herps community that stepped up, because without the Herps community, we would have been homeless. We were homeless for less than 24 hours after Hurricane Delta left over 2 feet of water in our home, and that's all thanks to the Herps community. Without them, we don't know where we would be today, and we were very grateful and thankful, and we'll never be able to thank everyone enough.
He has a different camera.
He has a different camera, yeah, and he's got the whole setup, bro. I'm poor. I can't afford all that.
Yeah. Wrap it up. It's like Christmas, baby. Wrap it up.
Look at all this plastic.
It's bad for the environment.
What do you think? How's that much plastic wrap?
It's bad for the environment, man.
That's the first thing.
Definitely not green. Did you do this? But Andy earned extra cuddles for this.
He had it up here on the dummy ears. I don't know why you got these out. You can't even see that far.
Jesus Christ.
So fast. Since you have it out.
I think that's absolutely an insane concept. Paying $1,000 for something that's about this big and can easily get away from you. Like, if it gets under your couch, just whoop, gone. So easy. You have to be so diligent about something like that. But they're so cool, and no one has them. So Bart just got an Australian frilled dragon. Tell me a little bit about him, Bart. What do you like about him?
He's Jesus lizard. They run, they hop up, they frill, Jurassic Park.
So tell the viewers what's different between the Aussies and the other kinds of frilled dragons.
So you have Papuan and you have Australian. The Papuan are a smaller, darker species. The Australian olive are frilled much brighter and grow to much larger sizes. They get very cool rust colors. Also, just have much cooler personalities, in my opinion.
That guy is bright. I love that coloration, the camouflage. Now, do they retain that color pretty well as they grow older?
They really do.
They really, so keep on a lookout. One day I'm going to go to Bart's facility and check out some of his stuff, and I'll show you his adults. So obviously the draw of the black dragons are the dark, melanistic attitude of them. So in your experience, what's the development of these guys? What's been the draw? How long do you think it's sticking around? Like, and what do you want people to know about these guys in general?
I think just in general with black animals, it's attractive to people. So like the black snakes, black lizards, I've always been interested in the black dragons, and I was so excited to get my first, and now I breed them and I have tons of them. They're incredible.
So for somebody who's thinking about saving up and dropping their dime on this versus something else, like what advice do you have for somebody who's like looking to get into them?
Just make sure you're prepared. They're a lot of work. They get very big. They need a lot of water, big space, a lot of clean water. They eat a lot and they poop a lot, so they're very expensive to keep. Just know what you're getting into for sure.
So definitely very rewarding, something that he's built a lot from and that he loves, but you have to look at that barrier to entry when getting these animals. So it's not just saving up for the animal. And I'm sure if you're looking to drop this kind of money, you've done that kind of research, but talk to somebody reputable. Blake has been in the community for a long time. He does a lot of great work, and he's just a great person to get some knowledge on these animals from, and that's why he's a great person to get the animals from. So the last part about being in this community that I want to talk about is how we build upon each other. We build upon each other's business, knowledge, just growth in general. So awesome designs come from sitting down and having these long discussions with each other on, you know, what would help benefit animals, what would help benefit things in nature. And so Brandon and I, we're friends with a lot of people who do this through methods such as writing, like, in medical journals, in, you know, in publications, articles. And then, you know, you get guys like me, and I'll put it out on a medium such as YouTube. So we reach a higher audience and group of people, and we love this. We're passionate about this, and that's why we're all here together, is just to share this ultimately. And it's great. It's the best. Do you have any final thoughts?
Hey man, for example, Venom Life, we started in February of 2019. As you can see, just walking around this one expo, not even vending this weekend, we've got so many vendors wearing our clothes, wearing our hooders, wearing our hats, using our keychains, selling our books from Get Hooked. And one of the really, really cool things is having that support. We wouldn't be anywhere near where we are within the last 2 years of having Venom Life without this community support. There's so much community support where these guys are working together to bring up each other's businesses and help the entire community succeed.
Exactly. And so as the community helps build Venom Life, that in turn helps build the Asclepius Snakebite Foundation, which helps people around the world. Literally, a small community helps people worldwide. And it's amazing to watch that at work. It's amazing to watch us help each other in the small community, just outside of it, family and friends of people in the community. And then it goes global like that. It's amazing. Guys, I appreciate you watching this video. Make sure you like, subscribe, bell notification, all that stuff really actually helps. The YouTube algorithm is weird and always changing. And here's the 2021. Awesome videos coming y'all's way. And I'll see you guys next time.
Without your support, we're just two guys with a camera walking around.
We're still just two guys with a camera walking around.